Hi, welcome to a video. In this video, we're going to be talking about the Samyang 85mm 1.4. Now, I've bought this lens a few months ago, and after I bought it and it arrived there, I read some reviews about the autofocus not properly working. Now, that's a bit of a situation, right? You already buy a lens and then you read it. So I want to be giving back to the community and show you guys how the lens performs in a real life situation. I'm shooting with an A7 R2 and I did a shoot on the rooftop. And well, join me in this video and I'll show you how the autofocus actually works. Let's find out. Alright, the 85mm is known as an ideal zoom range for portraits, so you want it to nail the focus on the eyes. As you can see, I'm using the lens on an A7 R2, so I can only speak for this brand and this camera. The A7 R2 uses somewhat older eye autofocus tracking, in which you have to press a separate button to search for the eyes. With the wide open aperture of 1.4, the slightest of movement can bring your subject out of focus. So this goes for whatever camera you're using. So for outside portraits, you want to add some dynamic movement to the shot. So I ask Nia to slowly walk or, for instance, do something with her hair. And I think there's the catch. If you want to nail focus on the eyes while you have a moving subject, you need a camera that can keep track of the focus on the eyes. So there are some reviews about this lens, about it doing some hunting. I had no problems with this whatsoever, and this includes shots taken outside on the go in low light situations also. Out of all the photos taken, the ones that were focused on the eyes came out tack sharp. And when the camera couldn't have a good track, it often had the face in focus, but slightly missed out on the eyes. Alright, so I hope this video gives you some insights about the capabilities of this lens and the autofocus problems. There, I didn't find any autofocus problems, and honestly, if you compare the price range also with the competition, that makes this lens super super interesting to buy. You've got the Sigma 85 1.4 for around $1,000, I believe, and this lens can be bought for around $500 or $550. So that makes it a pretty good option to buy. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you enjoyed this video, please thumb up and subscribe. See you in the next one. Thanks.